If you believe a student can learn, that student will start to believe, yeah, I can learn. And that was the genesis.
For them to solve the future problems of our nation, we must educate them to do science inquiry, to problem solve.
And not where it's very rigid and inflexible, but making it fun, making it imaginative.
6.02 times 10 to the 23rd.
That is correct.
We want them to land in careers that have real meaning and value.
When I finish school, I want to be a marine biologist.
Architectural engineer.
Pediatrician.
OBGYN.
Anesthesiologist.
And that more importantly, they are leaders in those roles.
We decided, I mean, 30 years ago, that the only way we were going to get a pool of good students was to join with the high schools. The applications for medical school from minorities, and particularly African Americans, was dropping. And Carmichael said, oh, we can do something about that.
My aim was to try to make them learn some chemistry and try to make them understand that they could learn chemistry.
Dr. J.W. Carmichael and a group of faculty members decided that they would create some kind of model where we would start tapping into high school students and not only helping them to develop that better sense of ability, but also that esteem.
But this was a ratcheting up of kids who were eager to learn. And for me, I call it the grandmother of them all, was the SOAR program.
Is abuse abuse if you do not know the definition of abuse? Y'all with me? Mm-hmm.
Stress and analytical reasoning, basically what SOAR is, it's a college prep program for students to prepare them for not just tests, but also the experience of college. And we're trying to train our students to have good verbal reasoning skills, quantitative reasoning skills. So our classes are very challenging. The work is very rigorous. And for that 3 weeks, they work from the time they get here to the time that they leave.
SOAR prompts students to think beyond memorization, really understanding the information and being analytical about it to garner a better understanding. And hence, I think that speaks to Xavier's success rate in placing students into medical school and graduate school and other levels of study, particularly in the science, technology, engineering, and math realm.
100. It's mind-boggling to really understand because the numbers are through the roof. Xavier has had the pleasure of being ranked number one in the United States for the past 25 to 30 years in the number of African Americans that we place into medical school. Number one in the nation. Now, we don't think that that's accidental.
One of the basic things that we try to do is to acknowledge that the teachers have the content. They know their fields, they know the math.
There's one side of it in terms of really working with the students and getting them to where they need to be. But oftentimes what we found is that the teachers themselves didn't feel very confident in their ability to deliver mathematical and scientific instruction effectively. And so there was a communion that actually happened where we realized that you've got to focus both on teachers and students in order to get these students ready for college.
Chemistry is not a textbook subject, it's a real life subject. So they must see the science, they must experience the science. So in lab, it allows them to connect the dots.
ChemStar is a summer program for kids who want to excel, for kids who want to jumpstart the next year. And I think that's really important, especially if you struggle, just so it's not the first time you're seeing material during the school year.
It helps you to broaden your horizons about chemistry and change everything that you know, things that you have heard about chemistry, such as, oh, it's too hard, is basically just gonna help you.
Research tells us that students, they learn from each other more than they can learn from a teacher-to-student relationship. It's one of those practices that we have not mastered as a whole in our educational world. As a teacher or instructor, I'm the facilitator, but it's all student-centered, and it's all student-driven.
Yeah, so you have to write your chemical equation and then balance it.
This summer, I'm actually doing breast cancer research at the Sidney Kimmel Comprehensive Cancer Center at Johns Hopkins University. I think it's very important to have bridge programs for STEM careers. Many of these areas are very difficult and it takes a lot of work to succeed. So I think it's very important to get that heads up before deciding what you want to do. When I did finish my last year of high school, I really made sure I developed good study skills. By the time I got to college, it wasn't as hard of a transition.
We need thinkers. So it's to build the students as thinkers and engaged in science instead of just being passive in it.
And this has been a crowning point of our summer programs as well, is that you've got to have that deep understanding of scientific concepts. When they come to our doors or any other university's doors, they will continue to persist and graduate from your university.
Education still is the answer to many of the problems that we have in this country, and it will continue to be until we invest more and spend more time closing the gap between the schools and colleges. And the Summer Bridge Program is an answer to that.